me clearly. America is not a racist country.
Ladies and gentlemen, this time it's South Carolina that passed measures so that African American history is blocked from being taught. And if anybody attempts to teach it, it opens the door for white parents to sue. I'm going to go ahead and play this video and I'll be back with my commentary.
We're starting this half hour talking about education. The South Carolina House is debating legislation that bans what some GOP lawmakers say is race-based teaching. News 19's Becky Buds is at the State House with details of what's the issue. Becky.
Republicans insist the bill prevents divisiveness in the classroom, while Democrats argue it will prevent the teaching of history and drive more teachers out the door.
In this state, I would pack up my stuff and I would quit right now. Because obviously the state cares more about politics than they do about you and the students.
And that's exactly what we're dealing with in this bill as well, to make sure that our kids in a public school do not receive instruction that a parent would not be able to support.
The South Carolina Transparency and Integrity in Education Act would prohibit teaching that an individual is inherently privileged, racist, sexist, or oppressive, among other requirements. Democrats proposed dozens of amendments that would have required teaching of Jim Crow laws, Dixiecrats, and making the bill include private schools. All of them were voted down by Republicans. Annie McDaniels represents Fairfield County.
So I've been through a whole lot in this state. So when you see us come up here and you see us talking about these things that we know are going to do damage to our communities, all I ask is you just try to take us a little bit serious.
If passed, the proposal would take effect for the 2024-2025 school year and require that school districts' websites include a list of approved textbooks. It also calls on schools to create complaint forms for parents to use if classroom material is discovered to be objectionable. Lawmakers voted to take out a parental pledge of responsibility.
Last time I checked, it wasn't parents that were the problem. It isn't parents that the government should be telling what to do.
If passed, the bill will then head to the Senate, where a similar proposal died last year, just days before the legislative session ended. Reporting at the State House, Becky Buds, News 19, WLTX.
Well, schools or other educational agencies found violating the proposed law or refusing to adhere to a correction plan could see up to.
All right, so here's another story, this time out of South Carolina again. They are making attempts and passing laws. Your lawmakers are doing this to get rid of Black history, African American history. And then they keep harping on white children, white children. White children are not the only ones that go to school in America. And I don't think this should be all about them. But this is what they have done and so far have gotten away with. And what they're trying to do is eliminate all of African American history, but tell you, your kids, it's mandatory for you to learn their history. That's where you should draw the line. You should not be subjected to their history, just like they don't want to be subjected to ours. It should be a choice. But if they tell you it's mandatory, that's a good court fight. It really is. But again, it's going to have to be up to Black parents. And I can tell you, it's going to be a very volatile year in education. The true colors are going to come out. And this argument that teaching the real true history, because that's what they're doing. They're trying to get the truth out of the schools, not that it was ever there. And replace it with some fake fairy tales that they have made up about their history. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's get into this once again. So they're saying they don't want critical race theory, and the GOP said that they wanted to reduce divisiveness. And I got a problem with that term. First of all, what era in American history was not divisive? And who started the divisiveness historically in this country. It sure wasn't us. We didn't start it. So if it's divisive, then the group of people historically that started this whole thing, you deal with that. I'm not concerned about divisive when we've always lived in a divisive way in America the entire time. I guess they came up with a word that they think is scary to people. It's not scary to me because I know we have never been united on nothing. So the word divisive means absolutely nothing to me. It's just endless word salad that you came up with. Indoctrination. Well, I would like to know, what are the people that you consider African American trying to indoctrinate you into? That's what I want to know. What are we trying to give us examples of what we're trying to indoctrinate white people into? I don't know what this is. You don't know what it is either. So anyway, I think you're going to have a choice. Again, I'm going to bring this up. You're going to either have to homeschool or you're going to have to send your children to school and know they're not going to learn a thing about themselves. So South Carolina House of Representatives on Wednesday passed legislation that bans what the GOP calls race-based discussion in K through 12 classrooms, allowing parents to sue the school district who break the law. So in other words, they're opening the door for white parents to sue. That's what they're doing. This is for white parents. This is not for all parents, y'all. The 83-24 vote fell among party lines. Republicans insist the proposal aims to reduce divisiveness, which has always been in America. All of American history is divisive. And indoctrination. And I don't know, please explain again what the Black community ever tried to indoctrinate white people into. I would like to know what it is, because this talk, divisiveness and indoctrination, is vague. It's vague. Give examples. How did we try to indoctrinate you historically? Please let us know. I invite you to come in my comment section. Let us know what we have gone above and beyond to indoctrinate white people into. Because I don't know what it is. This is just word salad, y'all. In the classroom, the Democrats worry it will prevent the teaching of history and drive more teachers out the door. I don't care about your teachers, quite frankly. They don't teach nothing anyway. So anyway, no, my concern is about, we got a country with different cultures, and all the other cultures, their history seems to be okay. It is just one group that y'all having issues with. That's because you got such a terrible, horrendous history with, and it's not like you're doing anything about it, even in today's standards. You're not doing anything to make it better. So, but that is supposed to be eliminated. That's the only history that disturbs you. So that's the only one that should go. Look like some fragility to me. So you saw what they said on the video. So they said the bill is, you know, they're saying they don't want anything and it's against the law. This will prohibit teachers from saying that white people got privilege, mention anything about racism in the classroom. So we're supposed to just get up, live through this in our daily lives, but not be able to speak about it. That's what they're trying to tell you. And see, that's why they get so angry over our channels online. See, they want to continue to carry these things out. Racism, sexism, you know, everything, right? And you are never supposed to speak or say nothing about it. See, freedom of speech for them, not for thee, right? For them, not for thee. So this is nothing but Jim Crow. Y'all, call it what it is. This ain't no indoctrination and divisiveness. This is Jim Crow. This is Jim Crow. They're going full throttle on Jim Crow up in these schools. That's all this is. So, ladies and gentlemen, if we got to depend on Joe Biden, nothing is ever going to change. They'll sit back and watch. They see what's going on in the country with education. They know this stuff is going on. And look at when they're passing these measures during Black History Month. Just take notice to that too. Now you got South Carolina pushing legislation, which did pass, to eliminate any talk about African-American history in their schools. And if you talk about it, we're opening the doors for white parents to now sue the school district. They're doing this during Black History Month. Just take note. Take note. So once again, we're back to Jim Crow, full throttle. Not that we were ever out of it. So South Carolina is another state that have made it against the law to teach African American history. It's against the law there. You bring it up, a white parent can sue. So it's up to families in South Carolina to take a stand against this. Otherwise, because right now they're running roughshod over all of us in the Black community. Your children too. It's against the law to talk about any trace of our history. That's what this is about. They can talk about indoctrination and divisiveness. I can see through the smoke screen. Y'all have to tell me what you think. Please leave your comment and subscribe. Don't forget to hit on the notification bell, and I'll see you on the next video. Peace, family.